Hello and welcome back to another Minecraft Bedrock Edition how-to tutorial. Basically, how to play Bedrock Minecraft. If you guys haven't seen the last video, definitely check it out. The link's going to be over here in the upper right-hand corner of the screen. Because basically what we've done on that basic video was go over the basic controls of how to play. So basically... Okay, I'll stop with the basics. What we're going to be doing is we're going to be going over some of the different settings on the main menu. Just to kind of go over a few things and, you know, kind of get you used to some of the buttons. So we're going to kind of start with the bottom and go and work our way up. So let's go right over here to the marketplace because, well, although it is a marketplace and they do have things that they want you to buy, there's actually a fair amount of free things. So it's worth to check it out. So let's go over here. We're going to hit the button down here at the bottom, which is the marketplace. And after we click it, it's going to take us to another screen of all of these different things that say it cost mine coins. Mine coins, well, if we click this button, it costs dollars or US dollars or whatever dollars are in your area or country. But it costs dollars basically to buy more mine coins. And of course, the more you buy, they give you extra little bonuses. But to try and find the free ones is very simple. If we come over here to this magnifying glass all the way up in the upper right-hand corner, similar to where the iCards are, we're going to go ahead and click that button. And then we're going to hit right here in the search bar, we're going to go F-R-E-E and see what comes up. Yeah, none of these are free. Free the fish. Let's see if I can find some free ones real quick. Ah, here we go. So on the main one from here, if you scroll down right here where it says education, these, all these maps and all these like texture packs, I think some of them are, you get for free. Now, albeit it is free, so they're not necessarily the best, I do like that they have the redstone guide on here. I bought that one like way back when, and it was actually for somebody else to try to help them learn how to do redstone. But if you do look, there are some other things too that are free. Sometimes like during different times of the year, they'll also have like free packs. And if they do pop up, I implore you to download them or even access them or whatever the case is. Let's see, if you usually go, I don't think I have any that I haven't gotten yet. But when you go to one of these, it'll show like right here, free. You click on it and it kind of quote unquote purchases the map for you, which kind of makes it worth it because at least you'll have that map forever. Because if it goes out of sale or it goes from being free to where they charge you for it, well, you've already gotten the free version of it, so you don't need to worry about paying for it again. So definitely check that out because it is definitely worth a look-see. Now, the other thing is, and I don't know why it keeps doing that. I think that's a bug. Because every time I go into the marketplace after I've had my skin on from my own skin pack, yeah, it just goes back to Steve. But anyways, let's talk about a little bit of the skin packs. So we'll go over here to the profile, which is right underneath my character that I'm spinning and moving his head up and down as I talk. If we click this right over here, the profile button, you can see, yeah, my skin is here, but it wasn't loading. But anyways, if we go, let's see, we got style. This is a custom skin that you can make, and they do have some free options, and this is what I'm gonna leave for you to maybe mess around with later because there's so many different options. It would be a long video to sit here and go over each one, but let's see if we can find ones where they're purchasable. Yeah, here you go. So these ones you do have to buy. If you want to unlock this one, it does cost a dollar, US dollars, which is also 160 mine coins. But if we click on the character over to the left, this one is actually free, so you could actually apply this and go back and go back and go back. Now I have that skin and it didn't cost me anything. So definitely do browse on the different skins right over here. Let's see, middle tab, purchasable, and just kind of scroll through there. Now I will say there are so many skin packs. It is quite redonkulous. I'm trying to figure out which one you might want. This looks like a weird green. Is that just me or does this just look like a weird grin? Anyways, there is a lot on here. So yeah, there's just quite a bit. And there's no easy search kind of like scenario or search engine to say, hey, I want this particular one or I want this particular type of skin. So like if you were looking for a ninja skin, they don't have anything where you can just click and say, hey, I want to search, like search bar. Yeah, they need to put a search bar on the skins. Maybe that's in recommendations on the feedback website, but I really don't know. But yeah, definitely scroll through all of these. There's many, very, very many like skin packs. Don't let this bar fool you, because this bar will constantly keep loading more and more and more and more and more. So yeah, definitely have fun with this. Now, if you don't want to necessarily look for like some of these free skins and look through some of these free skins and you don't like necessarily what they have, there are other options out there for you. Well, at least for the ones that are on Windows 10. I don't know about, and possibly even Android. I don't know about Xbox or PlayStation 4 or even iOS, because I know Apple has like a lot of restrictions on what kind of things you have access to or what you can download. But if you go to your web browser, and for me, we're going to be using Google Chrome, but if you go over to your, I have a couple of different ones. Minecraft skins basically.com. If you go to that website, there is all different kinds of skins on here that people create, and basically you have a search bar. So if I wanted to search ninja, I can do it just by clicking or typing it in there, hitting the search button, and then it gives me everybody else's like ideas for a ninja skin. No, this is not where I got my skin from. But they do have some pretty interesting ones that I've actually downloaded because, well, my son wanted one. But yeah, these are definitely the skins that you could get and you could utilize on your Minecraft world on Windows 10. And in order to do that, you basically pop into, let's see, we'll just grab this one. And then you can see right here over here, it says to download, and then it'll download it. And then whenever you go back to Minecraft, you can actually go back over here to where it says owned, and then where it says import, choose new skin, and then it's going to pull up a window for you to search through your files. And for me, I have a particular folder that I go to for all the different skins that I do have. Here's one that I've actually downloaded from that site. Let's go ahead and open that up. And there you go. So we actually got like a boss zombie boss. I don't know what to call him. He's not really a boss, but like in a suit. It's kind of weird to have a zombie in a suit. I don't know. My son wanted it. I downloaded it, kind of added it to my own special skin pack right here. Yeah, and then there's that. Now, if you guys are interested in my skin pack and you guys are interested in all the different skins that I have here, yes, this is one that my son wanted. Same thing with this zombie. My son also wanted that one and this one, so I kind of just added it to my own personal skin pack. If you guys want to see this skin pack, you can get it from my Discord, and you can find it right over here in TNC links, and it should, yes, it's not in here quite yet, but I do have my texture pack for my TNC's texture pack, and let's see, I think I have it in TNC downloads. Yeah, this is my ninja skin, or my TNC pack right here, and this is my NinjaCraft texture pack, which I have in downloads. Now, this downloads chat is basically access to TNC supporters only at this particular moment, but I'll definitely throw the skin pack over here on TNC links for you guys whenever you decide to come and join and hang out in my Discord. Definitely come hang out, because we do some pretty funny things and pretty cool things, so yeah, definitely head on over. And there we go, now we have got back my regular skin, or my other, you know, this skin. Now, the next thing that we're going to go to is we're going to take a look at some of the settings. And if we click on the settings right here, you can see where it's got the controls and stuff that I've talked about on the last video. It even goes into your profile where, you know, I kind of don't really mess with any of this stuff because I don't know what none of this stuff does or doesn't do. I have no idea, to be honest, but there's credits, attributions, license of content. You can change your gamer tag, manage your account, which basically pulls up the console companion, manage who can send you invites. Let's see, content log settings. I'm not sure exactly what that does. And this says delete all content log. So I'm not really sure how all this works. But then we also have the video settings, which you can adjust your brightness. Usually I have mine all the way up. the reason why it was only at 50 is because I was downloading and uninstalling and then re-downloading Minecraft for the beta, so it kind of does that. Plus, you got full screen, hide your hand, paper doll. These are like the HUD, basically like what you see in-game on screen. The opacity, so like if you want it to kind of maybe be a little bit transparent, you can change that. You can also change the safe area, which has these arrows over here. Mine is always max because I have 1080p on my computer. Plus, they have a bunch of other things, view bobbing, fancy leaves, bubbles, clouds. Some people usually like to turn that one off. I have it to where I turn it on and or off depending on what I'm doing in-game. They also have your UI profile, which you can go to Classic, Pocket, or, you know, whichever one you decide to use. GUI scale modifier, your render distance. I usually have mine at 24. Particle render distance, you really don't need that much. I usually have it about 4. But like I said, it changes every time I uninstall Minecraft and then reinstall it. Now, if we go to the audio, we always have the audio settings. Mine's usually set to music, always 0. Sound volume's usually set to 45 because it's not too loud for me, whether it's on my desktop or on my headphones. Then you have global resources. These are your skin packs or your texture packs, I mean, should I say. And you can also get some of these texture packs also for free whenever you download some of those worlds. But some of them might be attached to that world, so you might not be able to use them separately. But yeah, sometimes you can get some free texture packs from the marketplace also. Then, of course, we also have storage. Again, I've never really kind of messed with this. Language, in case you wanted to change the language. And then there's also a how to play if you want to read all of this stuff. Hey, more power to you. It's a lot to read. I haven't even read it myself. I've just kind of jumped in and started playing, and yeah, that's pretty much it for this. Now that we've gotten the settings tabs taken care of, let's go ahead and look at the play tab. This is probably the main one and the most common used tab. Now you can see right here where it says worlds at the top, I only have one. And that's because we're on the beta, and like I said, we've downloaded and uninstalled Minecraft many times, switching to and from the beta. But if we go over here, the first thing that you would see is probably not any worlds. If you've, you know, started Minecraft for the first time, you would come over here to the create new tab, and then you want to create a new brand new world to kind of get things started like we did on the last video. And so when we come in here, trust me, you guys always want to name your world something, because I'll tell you what, you get so many of my worlds, you'll never know which one's which and what you were doing. At least have an idea. What do I want to do with this world? Well, I want to be in creative, so you could put creative testing or something like that. Obviously, it maxes out on the amount of what do you call these things? Text, like individual things. I don't know. You guys know what I'm talking about. But you can also go into your different game modes. This is where I was talking with you guys last time in the last video, where I was in creative. And that's what you would want to do maybe if you want to try and get used to the controls and get used to building. They also have different difficulties where you got peaceful, you have easy, normal, and hard. So peaceful, basically what that does is it will not spawn any hostile mobs in the game at all. You'll get cows, you'll get sheep, and you'll do all that stuff. And that's where a lot of people actually start with their survival worlds, because they want to get used to the game, used to what's happening around them. And if this is the first time you've ever started playing Minecraft and you want to do a survival world, that is what I would suggest you do, because you won't lose any health and you'll kind of just survive in the world a lot easier. Then once you get comfortable with it, I would say go to easy. You get even more comfortable with it, I would go to hard, which starts to spawn more and more hostile mobs. And then the best way to play, maybe just me personally, is on hard mode, because, well, I always like that extra challenge. And then again, if you start for the first time, I would suggest do a starting map and a bonus chest, because those things always kind of help you get things going and started. Now, we also have this player permission when joining from an invite. So basically, if you invite somebody to your world, they'll have certain permissions. You can kind of read through what permissions that it gives them. But for now, I would just leave this at default for member, because that's how you're going to be playing, and I wouldn't suggest changing it to anything else. Now, the seed information, you can go online and search for different seeds just like I have in the past, or you could just leave it blank and it'll pick a random seed for you. And so you kind of really need to worry about that too much. But if you are interested, go on YouTube, type in Minecraft Bedrock Edition seeds, and trust me, there's a lot of people doing seed showcases. Now, if we take a look at the simulation distance where it says 10 chunks, my personal recommendation is to not do 10 chunks because that is a very large area in Minecraft that it will simulate and spawn like different mobs. Well, with the new mob mechanics in the beta, you won't have to necessarily worry about that, but it's basically how far you can go away from your redstone builds and them still operate. If you want to go higher than just 4 chunks, I would say go to 6, but I really wouldn't recommend going to 10. That just seems to be a little bit of an overkill, and you might run your world down even on single player. Now, the way I play on single player is actually at 4 chunks, and it's just because it's easier to keep everything in control as to where my villagers are, where my villages kind of link to each village and to their beds. If I have it at 4, I can actually go not that far from the village and it'll unlink from the villager. The villager will unlink from the village that it's at. Yeah, I know. I'm sorry. That's probably a little bit more complicated. But my suggestion is, like I said, just leave it at 4. It'll be easier in the long run to handle your world. Now, let's take a look at some of the world options that they have right here. Now, we have friendly fire. This is basically whether or not you want to enable PvP between you and anybody else that might join your world. They can also show coordinates where it shows over here in the upper left-hand corner where it says create new world. That's where you would see your coordinates in game. Now, coordinates are very useful, especially when it comes to builds, and I would recommend always having that turned on. Fire spreads, you know what, that's all up to you. Me personally, for my worlds, because I like to build with wool and wood, I always turn mine off, because if you ever get any lightning storms and a lightning hits your wooden build, that sucker will catch on fire and it will spontaneously combust basically your wooden builds. And then for the rest of these, I would recommend having these all on. Now, since I am on the beta, we aren't worried about the experimental gameplay, and we can turn cheats on or off if you so decide, but if you're going to be on peaceful, I would recommend having it off because you really don't necessarily need to worry about any of these other kind of buttons and stuff. But if you wanted to activate cheats, you could put on education edition, which kind of gives you some tidbits of information, basically like tips on the screen, I do believe. Do daylight cycle. So if you don't want it to be nighttime, you can turn this off and then turn always day on, and then it'll always be day. But I mean, I wouldn't necessarily suggest that because you wouldn't really get used to the night and day cycles for your first world. Now, you could put keep inventory on, and what this means is that if you turn this on, you die, you won't lose any of your items in your inventory. Me personally, I never see the point in keeping that on, except for when my son plays and we play on a skyblock and he constantly jumps out of the world. So if you're playing with your kids, definitely put it on. If you're not and you're playing on your own, you can turn it off and leave it off. Then there's also mob spawning, which will turn off any mobs from spawning in your world. But like I said, you're not going to get used to the game if you have that turned off. You also have mob griefing, which if a creeper explodes, it won't destroy any of the blocks or any of your build around you. But if you're on peaceful, you won't necessarily have to worry about it because they're not going to spawn any hostile mobs anyways. Then they also have entities drop loot. So if your mobs in the game, you kill them, this being armed, they will actually drop items. So if you kill a sheep, it will drop wool and also mutton. If you turn this off, it won't drop anything. Then they also have the same thing as the daylight cycle. We have a weather cycle. So if you never want to see it rain and you never want to see it thunderstorm, you can turn that off. But, you know, it's always good to fish while it's raining. thing, so we'll keep that on. Then, of course, command blocks. That obviously is another thing that is a little bit more advanced than this video, which, hey, you know, maybe we'll get into some command blocks later on in this series. Now, this is all the information that we have for the game tab. Then we also have the multiplayer tab. So if you want somebody to join your game, leave this on. If you don't want nobody to join your game, just turn that off, which most of the time I do, so this way you guys don't start jumping in my worlds. The only thing is, since I'm on the beta, I usually don't have too much to worry about, so I can leave that on. Then we also have resource packs. These are some of the packs, like I was telling you, that you can get from the marketplace that you can apply. Plus the one, like I said, in my Discord you could download, which is right here. And then you could activate that also on the world file. So if you ever decide to take your world and you want to send it to somebody, you could put this pack on the world, send it to somebody, and it'll have all that information on there. So you only have to send them the world. You won't have to send them the world plus the resource pack and the behavior pack. Now, the behavior pack is also another thing I've talked to you guys about in my Let's Play world, and this is a behavior pack to change how things kind of behave in the world, basically. And what they do is, for an example, if you want, we'll just say, a creeper to not explode, they have behavior packs that allow it to not explode. Kind of like Cobble Clicker, if you guys ever seen that in the marketplace. It's just another world that you can download, and it'll have different behaviors in the game, kind of like a modded version of Minecraft. So basically, it's not vanilla. So now that we have a bunch of settings set up, we are going to be survival, peaceful. We're going to put the starting chest and the bonus chest on. We're going to do a random seed. We have our simulation at 4 chunks. We want the coordinates to show. We're going to turn off fire spreads. We're going to turn off cheats because we don't want any of those cheats on. And we're not going to use experimental gameplay or anything of that nature. We're just going to hit create. And this is going to load us into a world where we get our starting map. As you guys can see, it says empty locator map at the bottom. If we open up our inventory, we can see that it's right here also. And when we right click on this empty map, what it is it's going to start showing you where basically you are in the world. And this one kind of puts us right in the middle because we're at 68.4. So we're not quite at 0.0, but we are pretty close. And this kind of gets us an idea of where we are and where we want to be. So this is spawn. If you want to stay here or even mark this in a sense, you could grab a couple of blocks like I have done on my Let's Play series, and you can kind of make a little mini tower and say, hey, if I die and I don't have a bed and I didn't set my spawn, this is where I'm going to end up. And if you guys are following along on my Let's Play, my Ninja Craft Let's Play, definitely check it out. Link's going to be up in the upper right hand corner of the screen on one of those fancy iCards. You guys would know that I've done this same thing, making a little dirt tower so I know where spawn is. Now, right next to where you spawn in the world, there is going to be the starting chest. And this thing is very useful because it puts a few torches around it, so that way it kind of tells you, like, hey, this is where it's at in case it gets dark and you can't find it. But usually it's close by. Even if you spawn on top of the side of a mountain, it'll usually spawn somewhere where, like, just in within the certain range of your vicinity. It's usually never more than 10 blocks away. So if we open up the chest, you can see we've got actually quite a few goodies. We've got a little bit of food. We've got some, like, planting stuff, and also 4 spruce saplings. This is actually a really good starting chest. And also, you know, some raw fish, which, like I said, this is just some stuff to get you started. And we even get a wooden pickaxe and a wooden axe. So that's always good to kind of start off with. Plus, you even get this chest. So lots of goodies and lots of good starting material in your world. Now, I don't want to get too far ahead and kind of start explaining how to survive and how to play survival, because, well, we're kind of already at we're past our 20-minute mark, and we're at about 24 minutes, so I think that's probably where we're going to leave the video for today, and we'll catch you on the next one. So without any further ado, ladies and gentlemen, thank you for stopping by in today's video, and I think we just watched a sheep get murdered by a wolf. Yes, that is one of the things that happens in survival Minecraft. But like I said, without any further ado, ladies and gentlemen, thank you for joining me today, and I'll catch you guys all on the flip side.